based on customer ID. It reads data from input Excel and writes output to an output Excel. There's a really simple flowchart. So we start by loading the customer IDs. We check if there are any left. If there are any left, we check the customer IDs, write the output, go back, and repeat this loop until all the customer IDs have been handled, and then we close all the files. So if we look how it's done with the standard robot, we must have everything in one test case because a robot framework doesn't really support repeat between test cases. So if you look here, I'll just go through the main blocks. This demo is in the GitHub. You can look it there a bit later. So we open the browser. We read the input Excel into memory. We get all the customer IDs into a list. We create the output Excel. And then the interesting part happens in this main for loop. So we go to the web page, wait until it is valid, it's loaded, and then we must have error handling, because if there's any issue in this web page, this will normally raise an error and it will exit this test case and test execution will stop. And this is really bad if we have, for example, 2-hour test execution and it happens to fail after 30 minutes. So we must sprinkle a lot of these run keyword and ignore error keywords so we don't accidentally exit the loop. So we basically type the code, get the result, and write it into Excel sheet. And after the loop is done, we'll just save the Excel output into a file. And because this is testing, I'm running some tests on my file, so I know that this happened properly. So it's a bit long. Lines are a bit wide. I use the normal robot style instead of keywords to show how much error handling actually costs. If we want to use robot flow, we need to draw the flow chart. So I have same flow chart boxes copied on this Y editor. We just connect the boxes. Here we have branch, so we can draw 2 arrows and from to end. And we want to know what happens in the branches. Also, actually, here we need to have the repeat arrow back here so we don't get lost. So we add text into here. So if customer ID is left is false, there are no customer IDs left. So we attach a text to this arrow and then we attach true into this arrow. So when the robot flow starts, it loads this flowchart. Actually, I'll switch to the one I created earlier because this looks a little bit better. So we start and we empty the robot framework test list and we give it the first test or the box we have, and it is the start. When the start task is executed, we give robot framework the next case, which is here. Then customer ID is left, and this is a branch. And branch execution is handled by output suite variable. If we want to look how it looks like with the robot flow, I'll check here. So here we have same boxes. We have start here, where we load the browser. Then we load the data. This is already, in my opinion, easier to read because there are small boxes. Here we are doing the branch, basically just checking whether we have anything left in the table, and we set the output suite variable either true or false. And then in the check customer ID, here we can get away with almost all the error handling because we can use test teardown. So if any of these keywords fail, the task fails and we go to teardown. And we have this teardown function here, and we can say run keyword if test fails, and we write Excel an error, so the end user can look at the Excel file afterwards and see there in a plain text which test passed and which text have failed. And I think I will show a quick demo. So we are running with --RPA flag, and then we specify the listener, and then we specify the robot file. And this flowchart file must have the same name as the test suite, so it will find and match. And as you noticed, there was one error, and because we are running robot framework, we have robot framework logs. And we can see exactly here what happened, because Selenium is nice. And also, if we look at the output, we can see that it handled all the normal working numbers, and when we had the unexpected error for 000 user ID, it brought error in the Excel, and we can then look into what is the problem. Thank you. Do you have any questions? If not.
Yep. So any questions?
Oh, one question.
All right. One question. Ah, sorry.
I saw that in your robot file, the last one that you showed, that you had a tasks. Is that a robot framework feature that we don't know about, or is that something you've added, or what is it?
It is for the RPA. Because in RPA, they are not tests, they are tasks. So basically, they function exactly the same as test cases.
So I don't know RPA.
No, it's robot process automation. It's exactly the same as test cases, but brings it closer to the automation.
And that's why you were talking about Dev 1 as the version?
Yeah.
Thank you very much.